welcome back. I hope everybody's staying safe out there dealing with Sister Rona, honey. She's trying to get us. We're going to be all right. Today, we are going to be making my amazing meatloaf. I love meatloaf, y'all. And as you guys know, everybody is pressed for groceries right now. We just kind of getting what we can get at the grocery store. So this is a great recipe that you can feed to your family, feed to yourself, and also freeze real, okay? So let's get to it. Going to start out with some light bread here. Now, you can use any bread that you want to, okay? But I had some light bread. It was fresh, too. That good old sunbeam bread. The one that stick to the roof of your mouth when you fry that fish. So good. Yeah, I'm using that today, baby. Okay, so I'm going to put all my bread into my bowl here after I just broke it apart with my hand. And if you made my meatballs before, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to soak this bread. This is going to make the meatloaf nice and juicy and tender and succulent. It's going to kind of melt in your mouth, honey. Yeah, baby, that's what you want. Okay, so we're going to just mush this down with the fork here just so that we can get all the milk into the bread, okay? And I'm going to let that sit for about 5 minutes to soak in that milk, okay? You want the bread to soak that milk up, okay? All right, so let's get to the meat. Now, I'm using what I could find in the store, so I'm using ground beef and also ground chicken. I have 1 pound each of ground, 2 pounds of ground beef and 1 pound of ground chicken. I'm using 3 pounds of meat because I'm going to give half of this to my parents who live down the street from me, and also the other half gonna stay with me in my house, okay? We're gonna eat that and be stocked up. So I'm gonna add my eggs. Now, we're gonna add 1 egg per pound, okay? So if you have 2 pounds of meat, you 2 eggs. All right, yay! Everybody passed in math class. Yes. So now I'm going to add my vegetables here. I've got some bell pepper and onion that I just put into the blender, and I just blended it up until it got like this. Now, if you just want to use your knife and chop it, honey, by all means, do that, okay? But make sure it's nice and fine like that, okay? We don't want chunks of meat or bell pepper up in there, okay? And onion, all right? They ain't going to be sopped up. We don't need that. We want it to be finely chopped, or you can put it in a food processor or a blender and blend it up. You know the recipe will be in the description box, so don't you worry. And I'm going to add a splash of Worcestershire sauce right there up in there to make that nice and sopped up. Get that tang like that. Make your mouth pop. Want that? Then I'm going to add in my garlic powder. I'm going to use 2 half caps full of that. That's how we measuring today, okay, up here in the sopped up kitchen. We are going to be using 2 caps of garlic powder. Just let the spirit lead you. I told you, everybody out there got some black in them. I don't care what you is. You got 1%, 2%, 3%, 19%. You got a little black in you, okay? So make sure you season, okay? Let the ancestors lead you with that. And then we're going to let our good old Grandma Hattie Mae, okay, that was born in 1800. She going to lead us with this beef bouillon powder, okay? We're going to use about a cap full of that. Now, be sure to not over-season the meat, y'all. But I got 3 pounds here, so that's a lot of meat. And I'm used to working with a lot of meat. Amen. Thank God for Jesus. Okay, so put that up in there, honey. Then we're going to put a little bit of salt. Okay, got some kosher salt here. Just about 1 tablespoon of salt because, you know, that beef bouillon does have salt in it. Okay, and I'm going to add some black pepper to that thing. Okay, because I like everything black, baby. You know what I'm talking about. And then I'm going to add a little bit, just a little bit of cayenne because we like a little spice over here. Okay, if you want to make it a spicy meatloaf, you can add a little bit of cayenne. And it's real good. Okay, then I'm going to add in my soaked bread. Okay, to that meat mixture. Okay, we're going to add that soaked bread to all of our meat mixture here. And we're just going to take our hands. Yes, I am. This is the best kitchen tool that you can have, y'all, is your hand. Okay, now, don't be using them gloves, because, honey, you know we need to save them gloves for the medical workers. And you know what I'm saying? When we go to the store and stuff, we need our gloves, okay? So use your hand this time. Use your hand. Just stir it around. Don't overmix it, but gently stir it around. Shout out to all of my medical workers out there. Thank you guys so much for all you're doing and your hard work. We really appreciate y'all. Just had to put that in there. Now I'm going to add in my barbecue sauce, okay? Give that a little bit of tang, okay? Want to add your barbecue sauce after you've kind of mixed it up the first time, then fold in your barbecue sauce, okay? That's what we want to do. Don't overmix it just until it's well combined. Maybe about 30 seconds or so, y'all, okay? So now I'm about to do, this is our hood gourmet tip of the day. Now, I realize a lot of you guys don't have no loaf pan out there, but that's all right, sugar. Let me tell you what we finna do, huh? We about to make a loaf pan. Sure is. Let me show you what we finna do right here. You're gonna take you some foil. Now, put it on a cookie sheet or a sheet pan. Take you some foil here. Look what I'm doing, okay? Get you the cheap kind, okay? Get you some dollar foil, all right? Because we know foil may be a little scarce, too. Get you some dollar foil, and then you're going to put your foil down just like that. Now what you're going to do after you put it down like that, I'm telling you, this is going to be good. I'm telling you. I've even made a banana nut bread in this little technique. Okay, now we're gonna put another piece of foil down over that, like I'm doing like that, okay? Put it down like that, and then put that one back over it, okay? Then what we gonna do now? We gonna take the edges up, okay? Look what I'm gonna do now, all right? Okay, we're gonna pull it up like that right there. Mm-hmm. Just make sure, you know, everything is on a flat surface here. I don't know what I was over there doing. My daughter was probably talking to me. But anyway, y'all see where I'm going with it, okay? Listen, let me tell you something. Just got to use what you got here. If you ain't got no loaf pan, you can make a loaf pan. So we're just going to fold those edges up, and we're just going to make a loaf pan. Sure is. Let me tell you something. Look at that right there. Huh. Ain't nothing you can, baby, you can do a whole lot with a little bit, okay? Let me tell you. So you're just gonna fold that up like that and push the sides together, okay? Just, we're gonna waist train this doggone loaf pan, okay? Push the sides in, okay? Make it nice and tight, okay? Put the sides in and just form you a loaf pan just like that. Look at that. Look at that. The reason why we want to do a loaf pan, if you don't have an aluminum loaf pan, you want to find, you want to make this, okay? Because we want to trap the juices in for the meatloaf, okay? We don't want to just form the meatloaf on a just a sheet pan and bake it, because the juice is going to just fall everywhere. They're going to spread out. We want to trap them in, okay? Trap the juices in. So you want to create a loaf pan, or if you don't have a loaf pan, create this. Or if you have a loaf pan, then you want to put it in a loaf pan to trap the juices on in there, okay? Make it soft up. You know, if you don't do that, it's gonna be dry as a what? Nun's vagina. And the church said amen. Okay, so I just sprayed my little handmade loaf pan here. That's what I did. I'm gonna put my meat down in there, okay? Look at that right there. We're just gonna put our meat down in there. And our homemade loaf pan. Baby, Sister Rona got everybody out here being, we just being creative, okay? But you want to do this, y'all, to trap the juices in, okay? Now, look, we're just going to take our hand and just spread it out. If you don't do this, them juices going to be running like Flojo, honey, across that pan. Ain't going to be sopped up. You want to keep the juices in. So just put your meat in there and just form this little loaf, your little loaf like I'm doing right there. So it's going to trap them juices in there and just smooth it out, okay? We don't want it to be rough on top, okay? We don't need that. Just smooth it out with your hand like I'm doing. Look at that. We are doing kitchen arts and crafts. Okay, I paid attention in vacation Bible school. I'm doing arts and crafts over here for y'all. Working hard over here on this channel. Okay, so we're just going to push that little stuff in like that right there. Look at that. Look what we did. We got a loaf pan. Now that foil that we had that was draped over the cookie sheet or our sheet pan, we just pull that up. Just to make sure we locked and secured, okay? We locked in, all right? So just pull that up like that right there. Like I said, we want to keep the juices into the meatloaf, y'all. You don't want it to run everywhere. You want to keep it in. This is why if you don't have a loaf pan, you need to do this step, okay? So we're just going to form our loaf pan like that. Look at that. Look at that, y'all. Can't tell me what God can't do. Look at that right there. Let me tell you something. You can't keep a player down. You can't keep a player down. Okay, we done made our little loaf pan. Now I'm going to bake this on a 350 degree oven for 50 minutes. Bake it for 50 minutes, and then it's going to come out looking really, really good. Before we do that, though, I forgot what I did. I did kind of like glaze mine a little bit with some olive oil just to get it nice and brown on top, but you don't have to do that. But look at that. Now we're going to bake it on 350 for about 45 to 55 minutes, okay? So do that, all right? You don't want to overbake it, so make sure at about 45 minutes you check it, okay? So look, now we're going to start on our glaze for the meatloaf. I'm not just using ketchup. I just don't want ketchup, okay? This ain't no hamburger. We want to make sure it's a good old meatloaf, okay? So I'm going to start with some Worcestershire sauce, the same thing we put inside the meatloaf. Then I'm going to add some barbecue sauce, just your favorite kind. I like Sweet Baby Ray's, okay? I think that'd be sopped up, okay? And then I'm going to add some ketchup, okay? So I'm going to use more ketchup than barbecue sauce, but I have to have the barbecue sauce in there with that Worcestershire sauce, y'all. It's going to be so good. It's going to be sweet and tangy. You know why it's going to be sweet and tangy? Because we are going to add our brown sugar. Now, this is going to allow the sauce to be sweet, tangy, and just downright delicious, but it's also going to let the top of the sauce caramelize when we put it back in the oven, okay? So we put our brown sugar in there. Simple sauce to go on top, y'all. We're just going to stir that around like that right there. Get everything sopped up. You ain't got no brown sugar, baby. Use white sugar. You ain't got white sugar? Use honey. Use agave. Use some, honey. Go pick a sugar cane and get some sugar. But you need a little sugar in there, okay? We're going to stir that up right there. And look at our meatloaf as it come out of the oven. You see those juices that's trapped in? All them juices would have ran out, honey. That meatloaf would have been dry. And then, folks, we're just going to talk about you Not in the group chat. We can't say the group chat because we're quarantined. But you know what I mean. So look at that, y'all. This is why you want to make a loaf pan if you can, if you don't have a loaf pan, because look at all those juices that's going to be there. See? That's what keeps the meatloaf nice and moist. That's what you want. Disregard that. We don't need that because baby, the hospital is already full of stuff and full of people, okay, with this virus. We don't need you going enough for a coronary bypass, okay? Heart attack because all that fat. We don't need that. So I just took the meatloaf out and I just put it onto my cast iron skillet here because we're going to pour the sauce on there. Look at that. Get it nice and glazed. Yes, honey. Let's sop it up. I like a lot of glaze on my stuff, okay? I want you to glaze it, honey. Glaze your meatloaf like that right there, y'all, okay? As much as you want on there. I didn't use all of it that I had in the bowl, but I did use maybe about half of it, okay? Because it did make a lot of glaze, okay? And it's delicious just to dip some french fries or something in it, okay? It's good. Okay, so I put it under my broiler for 5 minutes on high. So once you put the glaze on, put it under your broiler for 5 minutes on high. And look at that. Look how caramelized it get. Look at that. It's so good. It's so sticky and sweet and kind of tangy, y'all. This is so good. And that meatloaf is absolutely delicious. So we're going to let the meatloaf rest for about 5 minutes. 5 to 10 minutes. Let your meatloaf rest before you cut into it. And then you can just slice it up like I'm doing right here. Look at that right there. Don't that look cute and pretty? Y'all, this meatloaf is so good. I literally had to get it out of my house because I was like, I didn't want to share it with my mom and them. I was like, don't come down here and get it. Don't come. We quarantined. Don't come get it. It was so doggone good. But y'all, I just sprinkled it with a little bit of parsley. You know, I got to do that for Instagram. Take a beautiful picture, okay? That parsley try to do what they want to do. AKA food grass, all right? And look, so good. Y'all, this meatloaf is tender. It melts in your mouth. It's so delicious. And I want you to pair it with my sour cream and onion mashed potatoes that I have coming up next. Y'all, I hope you guys enjoyed this recipe. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate all of you guys. I hope you're staying safe. I hope you're staying prayed up. And I also hope you're staying clean. Again, thank you to all of our medical workers and also essential workers out there. We thank God for you. And we just thank you for working hard for us. Guys, please take care of yourselves. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.